Right, it's 1 PM and I gotta type out my marketing report proposal. My boss sucks donkey balls. Oh, let's go play with that cat on our second computer. Fuck yes. What's going on here? Oh, it's Breakout. Hello, welcome to Breakout. This is a game about breaking out. How ironic, as we want to break out of our office right now. Look at the aim of this game is to get as much spin as possible on the ball without it going down. Watch this. You gotta slice the ball like try to get it as. This is the meta of this game. You gotta get it as horizontal as possible like that. There you go. Look at that shit. All right, I've succeeded and I've completed the game. Can we go back over there, please? No, I can't. Hello? There we go. Right. What's down here? Smiley faces. Oh my god, it's my secret booze stash. What's jinx jig jays face? I am a pirate. I have pirate shoes. Pirate shoes make me we sail faster in the wind because pirates are the best parrots. Cool too. Alright. Oh my god, more. I need more inspiration sounds. Oh, hello. What the fuck is that? Who are you? Who's in my car with me?
Fuck this. I need a drink.
Fuck this. I need a drink after drinking two bottles of liquor in my cabinet. What? Okay, sneak out of the office. Let's do this. This is like the stealth segment of the game, huh? Well, don't interrupt me while I'm ignoring you.
Where the hell are you going, Carol?
Oh,
you think
nothing. I'm in my office.
You're the only joke around here. Tell you what,
I wasn't
you go.
Doing anything.
Have fun. Take the rest of the day off. The rest of the month.
Oh, thanks.
You're fired, you drunk.
Damn it. How did you know I was drunk? Can you smell me? Sneak out of the office for a drink. Fuck, he's coming. God damn it, that is a cute picture. Look at that fucking kitty. I am so wasted right now. I could stare at this for hours. Look at the eyes. He's got whiskers coming out of his eyes. What the hell? Kind of weird. Alright. He's walking away. You what, mate? You fucking what? I'm escaping. You fucking what, mate? You wanna go? You wanna go, mate? I'm gonna hide in, where the fuck this office is. Oh my god, it's a nice green chair to hide behind. He'll never see me here. I want to bust your nuts, you fucking cunt. You what? You what, mate? Yeah, you what? You fucking what? I'm out of here. Don't tell anyone you saw me, Walker. D Walker. Alright, let's go. What the fuck is that? Alright. Strange music. Is that James Jackson from the club? Roof or bar? Roof or bar? I guess roof. We gotta find out who the fuck that dude was, right? Oh, third person. Oh my god. He's gonna jump. He's gonna commit suicide at work.
Hey! Be careful out there!
Yes, because that's what you shout at someone who's about to commit suicide, right? Be careful, you might commit suicide. Be careful, you might fall off the ledge, which is probably what you went there to do in the first place. But be careful, you might fall backwards and accidentally not commit suicide. Oh well. Who the fuck is this? It's gotta be James Jackson, right? There's no other reason why his name would be in here. James Jackson, you look like a fucking serial killer. Ooh, spin your card round and round. This has no orientation to my mouse at all. You live on 123 North State Street. That's not a made up place. This doesn't interest me at all. I remember you, buddy.
Hey, James.
Remember me from the club?
Do you remember me?
Probably you fucked me.
I have your business card.
My house.
Rough day? Why don't you come back here so I don't need to shout?
Do I remember you? Just leave me alone. I'm fine where I am.
Obviously not, because you're about to jump off of a building, which is something normal people don't do. The fuck is this shit?
Divorce.
Oh, divorce.
I'm sorry about that, James.
50% of people get divorces.
But you'll
not
be
a
okay.
Reason to commit suicide.
You'll wake up tomorrow and do what you gotta do to make it through.
I knew the papers were coming. I ruined what we had.
What papers? Oh, divorce papers.
15 years screwed. But you didn't have to take my kids.
That bitch took your kids? How dare she? I totally agree. She should never have done that.
You're right,
what a bitch.
James. She shouldn't have done that. I understand.
I don't even...
Why don't we go get a drink?
I always pick them up after school. This is my time. Now I don't even know where they are.
Just look them up on Facebook or something. I'm sure they got like a status update. Kids always do that. Just left school. Just eating a... drinking a milkshake at... Never mind. What the fuck is this? Oh, it's a watch. It's also a few minutes to 4 p.m. If I wait here and admire his watch for a few minutes, this game won't make sense because it'll be after 4 p.m. Admire.
This
it's
is
a very
beautiful,
nice...
James.
Watch. You
did your dad give this to you?
Floor.
My grandfather gave me that. My father never made a dime.
What's it doing
he
on
just,
the floor?
He was just there.
But he was there, right? My dad's not around anymore. All I have is a photo that I can barely look at. I'd rather he was still alive. That he was just there.
But what if people can't change?
It's very emotional.
I've done so much harm. I just don't know.
I don't really know either. What harm have you done? I don't... What is this? Oh, it's a wallet. Oh, look at your kids, James. They're beautiful. One is black with dark hair, one is white with blonde hair. Kind of leaning towards the idea of there's an ant on my monitor. That's really weird. I'm leaning towards the idea that maybe one of your kids is not yours. Children, yes.
This
might
is
be
a
problem
photo,
with your children.
James? Why don't you come and tell me about it?
I don't want to. That picture's got nothing to do with you. Put that
down.
That'd
be nice.
Leave them alone.
Tell me about your family, James.
What
family?
Tell me how it's broken up.
Don't you get it? She's gone. She's gone and my kids are gone. I've driven them away. The only one that I can't drive away is you, Caroline.
How'd you know my name?
Me?
What?
You don't
you
even
had
know
sex
me.
With me.
I'm just telling you,
you had sex
how
with
important
him.
A father is to his kids. Think
don't
about you. That, James. Be honest with yourself.
Honest with myself? Caroline, your father died in a car you were driving, and you don't even remember being there. Why are you here?
What?
Why is it always
it's
you?
Dream.
I wanted to lie to you, to save you at least. But what's the point? When are you going to start being honest about what happened with your dad, Caroline? It's not good enough just to forget. Every drunk night, every morning after, a reset, a fresh start. I don't know how hard you'll hit your head in that crash, but every time they try to help you remember, every time you get close, you drink yourself into oblivion. You can hardly remember yesterday, but you just keep drinking. Maybe it's not a bad thing. Maybe it's a blessing. Caroline, I can never forget you. And my wife will never forget what we've done. Sometimes I wish we'd never met all those months ago. that this crazy affair never started. That I'd stopped meeting you again and again. This job, this bizarre relationship. I've lost my family for this. I guess it never got old for you. That I never got old. How many one-night stands have we had? My life
one,
is ruined.
Technically, after that it's
I'm
not
being
a one-night
stand.
After the
but I thought
one.
I could spare you from the truth. Yet here you are. I never thought it would come to this.
Alright, I have to make a blame... Sorry, I'm getting distracted by this ant on my monitor. I'm watching it, like, run around. It's crazy. Right, blame or understand you? I kind of understand you, but I also blame you for... I don't know. I think I understand you, even though I don't understand what I understand.
How long has this been... How long have I...
Hello, Betcha. How...
You can't lie to someone to save them, James. And if I'm lying to myself, then so are you.
What?
I'm not
that
important
make sense.
Right now. Think about your children.
I...
Think about your black and white kids.
I want to see them so much. Do you think they could forgive me?
Probably.
Do you think... You could?
Yes. I guess so. I'm gonna make a call. Don't commit suicide. Oh, that's the end. Well, there you go. 4 p.m. An interactive narrative novel that's your own fucking story. Something. So, right. That's... I don't understand the ending. She calls her mother. Does that mean she's kind of... solved her problems? The game said it dealt with alcoholism and suicide, but it didn't really go into those issues very much. I mean, it showed someone that's about to commit suicide, and also showed someone that was drinking. But just showing it doesn't mean you're dealing with the issue. I mean, I don't feel like I learned anything about alcoholism or suicide. That's the point of these things. Also, the whole game seemed to be relying on that twist too much. It's the kind of thing you do in college. Maybe this was done by a college student. If so, then yeah, it's alright. If you're charging for this and if it's a piece of art, then I think... I don't know. It just felt like a very generic kind of story. I don't know. Maybe I studied film, so I'm more... used to these kind of stories being done. Like, it's a very classic kind of, you thought it was this and then it was that. Oh no, we were having sex the entire time. Maybe I'm being a bit too critical of it. I think this game was distinctly average as an experience. As you compare it to Gone Home, I much preferred Gone Home. I mean, the writing was fantastic in Gone Home. The atmosphere is really good. This one was just kind of... Yeah, it was alright. It also made me feel fucking nauseous. But my opinion doesn't count. It doesn't matter a single piece of crap. I'm just expressing what I feel. What I would like is for you to tell me what you thought of it. What you got out of it. What did you think about it? Did you enjoy it? Did you think it was well written? Did you think it was good? Or did you think it was a piece of crap? Let's have a discussion, because... That would be fun. National Film and Television School. Alright, so maybe it was done by a student. Anyway, this has been 4 p.m. game. 4 p.m. the game, rather. Or the whatever interactive shit you want to call it. It was in memory of a good friend and tutor, Chris Hill. I had a tutor that actually died when I was studying at university. And that was kind of sad. We don't know whether it was suicide or not. But we were having a lecture once, and no one goes to his lectures, but he put so much effort and so much effort and enthusiasm into his lectures that I would always go. I never went to any other lectures, but I would go to this guy's lectures. And out of like 40 or 50 students, like five of us would turn up. At one time, he just closed his laptop and he was just like, why the fuck do I do this? Why do I even bother? And we were kind of like, well, we care. And then he was like, all right, fine, I'll continue for you guys. But I was really sad. He died like a few months later. And no one, they won't tell us whether it was suicide or not. But I kind of feel like the game could have dealt with the depression a bit more in a real fashion. It seemed very plasticky to me. And coming from something close to my heart, I feel like it could have done a bit of a better job. But there you go. This has been 4 p.m. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Subscribe. Bye.